Israeli laws targeting Palestinians. 1950-1966. Reverberations of 1948 Palestine War and the Arab-Israeli conflict. Israeli law of return in 1950. Every Jew has the right to settle in Israel as an immigrant. The law gives Jewish immigrants automatic rights that no other non-Jewish potential immigrants may enjoy. It also grants Jewish residents unconditional rights as citizens that no other non-Jewish native could enjoy. This will facilitate the Knesset debate on a citizenship law and enable the adoption of a decision on who will be granted citizenship and who will be denied this right. The Knesset enacts the nationality law in 1952. Israeli citizenship is acquired by return, or residence in Israel, or birth, or naturalization. This means that all Jews who resided in Palestine on the 14th of May 1948 are considered Israelis. Acquisition of citizenship by birth is conditioned on one of the parents holding Israeli citizenship. All other inhabitants need to apply for naturalization by meeting a number of conditions. Drafters of the Israeli nationality law succeed in avoiding the usage of terms such as Jew or Arab or any reference to a religious community. The Knesset adopts the entry into Israel law in 1952. The law constitutes the first Israeli regular instrument to deport people who enter Israeli-controlled territory without a permit from the Israeli Ministry of Interior. The law does not distinguish between entry by sea, land, or air, or between foreigners and potential Palestinian returnees. The term infiltration, used to describe Palestinians' attempt to return, does not appear in the law. The Knesset adopts the law of state education in 1953. The law specifies the following aims: to base education on the values of Jewish culture and the achievements of science, on love of the homeland and loyalty to the state and the Jewish people, on practice in agricultural work and handicraft, on pioneer training and on striving for a society built on freedom, equality, tolerance, mutual assistance, and love of mankind. It ignores the educational goals for Arab students in public schools. The Knesset issues the Prevention of Infiltration Law in 1954. The law is part of the Israeli campaign to prevent the return of individual refugees across the ceasefire lines and to expel Palestinians who reside in Israeli-controlled territory unlawfully. The law establishes special military tribunals to punish infiltrators and those who shelter them, determines categories of punishment to be applied, and allows the tribunals to deviate from the rules of evidence if this assists the discovery of the truth. Thank you.